will now take up all these tissues which we have discussed earlier one by one. The first one that we are talking of is areolar connective tissue. Areolar connective tissue is a loose connective tissue and it has three different types of cells. These cells are, first one, fibroblasts. These are large, irregular cells with long protoplasmic processes. Long processes, like long extensions. Fibroblasts secrete proteins. The proteins which are secreted are two, collagen and elastin. Now this collagen fibers, they provide tensile strength and elastin fibers provide elasticity. Collagen fibers are white, the collagen protein is white and that is why these are also known as white fibers. Elastin fibers are yellow, so they are also known as yellow fibers. So when we talk of white fibrous tissue, we have more of collagen. When we talk of yellow fibrous tissue, we have more of elastin. Collagen are unbranched, collagen fibers are unbranched and they always occur in bundles and are in bundles. The second one, that is the yellow elastin fibers, they are branched and they are normally single. Single fibers are there and they are branched. That means when we draw collagen fibers, we would draw it like this, unbranched fiber in bundle, and when we draw elastin fibers, we draw them single where we show branchings. So this is the first type of cell, that is fibroblast. The second type of cells are known as macrophages. Macrophages are large phagocytic cells. That means these are the cells which are going to engulf the foreign particles. And third category of cells are known as mast cells. Mast cells are large, slightly ovoid, not irregular, but little oval. And they secrete three important substances. One is histamine, which is secreted as or during allergic reactions. So whenever an allergen enters, it stimulates the secretion of histamine and that is what causes all those allergic reactions. And the drugs which are taken against allergy are known as antihistaminic drug. The second substance which is secreted by mast cell is heparin. Heparin is the anticoagulant which is present in our blood. It doesn't let the blood clot. And third substance is serotonin. Now it is said that serotonin is stored in mast cells and serotonin has various functions, like it can be a neurotransmitter also. So these are three substances which are secreted by mast cells and these are the cells. Now we said when we were talking about the brief classification of connective tissue that connective tissues, they have cells and the ground tissue. So if we draw the connective tissue, that is the areolar connective tissue, we would show there is this ground tissue. This ground tissue is the matrix part, which is also secreted by the cells. Then there are these large fibroblasts with these big protoplasmic processes and a prominent nucleus. And invariably, with these large cells only, we would find the fibers also associated. So Let us draw collagen fibers secreted by these fibroblasts only. Collagen fibers arranged in bundles, normally found with the fibroblasts. We will draw few more bundles. And now let us draw a few elastin fibers. Elastin fibers are branched and single. Collagen is unbranched and in bundle. So these are the elastin fibers. So we have drawn fibroblasts and the fibers which are secreted by fibroblasts. Let us label this. This is fibroblast. This is collagen and these are elastin fibers. And this material which we have written or filled here is the matrix, that is the ground tissue. Two more cells are to be drawn, that is macrophages. Macrophages are large irregular cells. Let us label this as macrophage, and the third one are the mast cells. So let us draw these mast cells, which are little ovoid. This is the mast cell. Now this tissue perfectly fits into the definition of connective tissue as well as the connective tissue proper. Connective tissue has to have cells, fibers, and the ground tissue in which these cells and fibers would be placed. Same thing is for the connective tissue proper. We also called it loose connective tissue. The cells and the fibers are loosely arranged in this ground tissue. Now, location. Where do we find these areolar tissues? Location of the tissue. Areolar tissue is found under the skin. It is also found under any kind of epidermis. So basically, just beneath the skin or any epidermal layer, there would be areolar connective tissue. And that is why we have or we show allergic reactions anywhere on the skin. If an insect bites, that also results into allergic reaction, and that reaction is seen anywhere on our skin. That means this tissue is under the skin, or we can also say under the epidermis. And this epidermis could be the outer layer as well as on the inner side. That means if this is an organ, here also this is epidermal, and on the inner side also there is epidermal tissue. So, just under that layer, we would find this areolar connective tissue. So, it is everywhere. And that is why we said in the beginning that connective tissue is widely distributed. It is almost everywhere in our body. And collagen fiber provides tensile strength. Yellow fibers provide elasticity. Macrophages help in defense. Mast cell has the following functions. It also is responsible for the allergic reaction and also produces heparin. So this is our one loose connective tissue, that is areolar. In the next part, we'll take up another loose connective tissue, that is adipose tissue.